Hello, I am Meghna and welcome to my class. Let's begin with the most important parts of speech, that is verb. It is an action word. It is used to describe an action. It tells about a person or a thing. Some examples of verbs are dancing, swimming, playing, eating, reading, etc. It is a doing word. We came to know what a person or thing does. Okay, like I am teaching. Here teaching is the doing word. Ram is playing. Here playing is the doing word. Rita is swimming. Swimming is the verb. Okay. Let's move on to another point. A verb may also tell us what is done to a person or thing. The pen is broken. Sweta is being scolded. Here, scolded, broken are verbs. I will tell you about some different types of verbs, like regular and irregular verbs, auxiliary verbs, modal verbs, transitive and intransitive verbs, verbal nouns, that is gerund and finite verbs, infinite verbs. Okay, let's continue. Regular and irregular verbs. We generally add D and ED to the end of the present form of the verb. These verbs are called regular verbs, like walk, walk theke walked hoy, ed jog hoy, egulo ed ar d jog kore je somosto verb kora hoy tader verb er past form toiri kora hoy taderke bola hoy regular verb. And some verbs does not follow this rule. Most of the times the in between letters change their position or add another letter to form that past form, like run theke ran. Ekhane u ta a te change hoye jacche. Okay, let's move on to another point, that is auxiliary verb or be verb or helping verb. Auxiliary verb helps to indicate the exact tense of the verb. Be verb, do verb, have verb, modals are also auxiliary verbs. Okay, let's learn about the modals. Modals are often used as auxiliary verb. Okay, and we have to use the present or the V1 form just after the modals. I can do it. Here the main verb is do, and the can verb or the modal is helping here. Okay, some examples are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, dare to, ought to, used to, need to, etc. Okay, now we will move to the another part, transitive and intransitive verb. Okay, a transitive verb used with a direct object and transmits action to an object and may also have an indirect object. A transitive verb has two characteristics. First, it is an action verb expressing a doable activity, like kick, want, paint, write, eat, clean, etc. Intransitive verb, a verb that does not need direct object to complete its meaning. like run, sleep, travel, wander, and etc. All are intransitive verbs. And now we will tell about the gerund. It is a verbal noun. Okay, it will form its formation from the verb and later it will act as a subject or a noun. Okay, let's learn. A gerund is a verbal verbial that ends in ing and functions as a noun. It occupies some positions in a sentence that is a noun ordinarily would. For example, subject, direct object, subject complement, and object of preposition. Infinite verb and finite verb. Okay, an infinite verb is essentially the base form of a verb with the word to in front of it. When you use an infinite verb, the to is a part of the verb. Some example of infinite verbs include to be, to have, to love, to eat, to run, to believe, etc. A finite verb shows agreement with a subject and is marked for tense. Finite forms of verbs of love like I love parrots, she loves parrots, and Pop loved parrots. A finite verb has a subject and shows tense. Examples: the thief escaped again. Here the thief is subject, escaped is the past form of the verb escape, and here escaped is finite verb and later part is object. Okay, here I am ending my video. Okay, thank you students.